16代目のクラウン、日本の歴史に重ね合わせればそれは明治維新です。ご覧ください、新しい時代の幕開けです。
Recent efforts by Toyota to rule the auto business have been incredibly effective. With their hydrogen cell powered cars, which are becoming more and more popular every day, they have opened up an entirely new market in the business. Toyota has begun working on a new method of utilizing hydrogen in cars, though, by inventing an internal combustion engine that uses hydrogen as fuel. What are the workings of this engine and why did Toyota design it in the first place? Is it superior to what Tesla is now providing? Explore Toyota's brand new hydrogen engine with us as we examine how it has taken the auto industry by surprise. Toyota has been a leader in the auto industry's innovation and has a significant part to play in the electrification of automobiles. The Toyota Prius, the all-time best-selling hybrid, was the vehicle that first ignited the electrified vehicle craze, accelerating the development of and boosting consumer interest in completely electric vehicles. Toyota's CEO, Akio Toyoda, has stated his opinion that hybrids and conventional internal combustion engines would continue to compete against EVs in the foreseeable future, despite the fact that Toyota has just joined the EV category with models like the Toyota bZ4X. By clicking on the top right corner, you may find out more information about this. Toyota has been working on fuel cell electric vehicles, FCEVs, often known as hydrogen cell-powered automobiles, as an alternative to electric vehicles despite their popularity in the hybrid and conventional vehicle markets. The fact that FCEVs use hydrogen, the universe's most abundant element, is their main benefit. Additionally, compared to EVs, FCEVs have a lower carbon footprint during production due to the less resource-intensive nature of the batteries used in hydrogen cell-powered vehicles. Like EVs, FCEVs also don't release any pollutants when being driven. When the first Toyota Mirai was unveiled in 2014, it was hailed as a technological marvel and became well-known outside of Japan. In 2020, Toyota unveiled the second-generation Mirai, which was made available everywhere. Other businesses have also dabbled in developing their own hydrogen cell-powered vehicles, including Honda, Hyundai, Volkswagen, BMW, and Mercedes. Toyota has recently made substantial strides toward more effectively using hydrogen, though. The Toyota Corolla GR and Toyota Yaris GR's popular 1.6 turbocharged three-cylinder engines have been successfully adapted to run on hydrogen rather than conventional gasoline. Toyota and Yamaha have also formed a joint venture to create a 5.0-liter V8 engine driven by hydrogen. But how does a hydrogen-fueled internal combustion engine work in practice? Surprisingly, it functions very much like cars that run on compressed natural gas. In order to securely store the highly flammable hydrogen, a bigger and more robust tank is needed. To manage the unique characteristics of hydrogen gas, engine components like valves, valve seats, connecting rods, and fuel injectors must be strengthened. Since there are no CO2 emissions, the overall use of hydrogen in these engines is almost identical to that of conventional fossil fuels. Similar to their conventional counterparts in terms of horsepower, these hydrogen-powered cars recharge remarkably quickly. The new Yaris GR-H2 takes only 1.5 minutes to fill up completely. As a result, these cars may influence the direction of the auto industry and grow in popularity over the next few years. Would you be interested in purchasing a car with a hydrogen-powered internal combustion engine? Which automaker would you prefer to see make them? Comment below with your thoughts and let us know. Before dismissing EVs and FCEVs entirely, it's crucial to be aware of a few problems and difficulties with using hydrogen as a fuel. Toyota is not the first automaker to create an internal combustion engine that runs on hydrogen. With the BMW 750HL in 2002 and the Hydrogen 7 in 2005, BMW previously debuted IC engines that ran on hydrogen. Numerous issues that still plague internal combustion hydrogen engine cars were present with these vehicles. First of all, hydrogen is extremely combustible and dangerous. Hydrogen storage and processing are also time-consuming and expensive processes. While hydrogen engines do not emit CO2 emissions, they do produce a lot of the pollutant nitrous oxide. Although it decreases engine performance, doubling the amount of air used for combustion lowers nitrous oxide emissions. Because of this, hydrogen engines must be bigger in order to produce enough horsepower, which reduces their fuel efficiency and increases their thrust. Furthermore, hydrogen is more expensive than gasoline and diesel due to the production and storage methods used today. Since hydrogen engines must be more durable, the manufacturing process is also more expensive. Hybrid vehicles now offer the best use for internal combustion hydrogen engines due to their much lower nitrous oxide emissions and improved fuel efficiency. Due to technological limitations, the mass distribution of vehicles like the Toyota Yaris GRH2 may not occur anytime soon, but long-term profitability for Toyota may result from continued development of this concept. Internal combustion engines that run on hydrogen could eventually be a practical choice. Thank you for joining us as we explored Toyota's groundbreaking hydrogen engine technology. From their successful endeavors in the car industry to their innovative approach in utilizing hydrogen as a fuel source, Toyota continues to push boundaries and shape the future of automotive engineering. Will hydrogen-powered internal combustion engines revolutionize the industry? Only time will tell. Make sure to subscribe to our channel for more exciting updates and discussions on the latest advancements in the world of automobiles. Drive safe and stay tuned for more informative content.